women are not tough enough, not fast enough, not strong enough, not determined. They fear true competition. They are expected to succeed in their sport while maintaining femininity. Femininity is about appearing small and vulnerable. Women do not possess the power to change the rules of sport. Because they lack the courage to win.
How is a female athlete supposed to look?
A lot of the male athletes that I know want to get a lot bigger and stronger than female athletes do. And I definitely know some female athletes who don't want to look too bulky or too muscular, so they try to stay toned.
The history of females in athletics has been a long and challenging road. To this day, there are still a great deal of battles that female athletes have to face based on society's perceptions of them. In the 1870s, physical exercise for women was thought to be dangerous and something that they were incapable of engaging in, even after countless examples of females being very well able to engage in physical activity. In 1874, Dr. Edward Clark published an article talking about a female's capacity for engaging in physical activity and stated both muscular and brain labor must be reduced at the onset of menstruation. The idea of a female being capable of physical achievement did not fit into their role in society, yet again taking away from their autonomy. Women were still viewed as property of their husbands, things or objects, as you may call them, and were beginning to show their yearning for their own identity. In the early 1900s, women began to form informal athletic clubs, such as tennis. During this time period, female athletics were solely composed of intramural competitions in which women would play against other women from their school. There were issues, though, that women encountered in which women's physical educators wanted to keep athletics in an educational environment for women. This idea really stunted the growth of varsity competition for female athletes. In the 1920s, the Women's Division Natural Amateur Athletic Federation was formed to organize intercollegiate competition amongst women. They developed a motto which said, "Every girl in the sport and a sport for every girl," which was viewed by many as taking the competitive aspect out of female athletics. During World War II, many women joined the workforce, which provided them with a great opportunity to show their competency and hopes that their success in the workforce could lead into people believing in their capacity for competitive athletics. Following the 1940s came a wave of social reform in which the civil rights movement was on center stage and helped create a wave of feminist activism. In 1957, female athletes secured a big win for their cause in which the Division for Girls and Women's in Sports amended a state to say that intercollegiate programs may exist for women. The movement for women in athletics started to rapidly gain momentum, in which they had national championships scheduled for gymnastics and track and field in 1969. While all of these important strides had been made, females were still lacking equal treatments in athletics. In 1972, Title IX was passed, in which it stated, "No person in the United States shall, on the basis of sex, be excluded from participation in, be denied the benefits of, or be subjected to discrimination under any education program or activity receiving federal financial assistance." The passage of Title IX allowed for an increase in female athletic participation, but there still remained the stigma in athletics of females not being taken as seriously as their male counterparts. To this day, there is still a great disparity when it comes to coverage of female athletes, which can lead to females posing on magazines such as Playboy or the Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition to try and garner publicity. This just further feeds into the problem of female athletes and their bodies being sexualized in society forcing them to find that fine line between the appeals of being feminine and the demands of their sport and needing to be strong.
I think the stereotype is that female athletes are supposed to look fit. There are definitely cases where it depends on the sport, but I think most sports do also require you to be fit and in shape and feel like you're skinny.
All women, according to society, are expected to appear feminine, which revolves around the concept of appearing beautiful and vulnerable. Femininity, by definition, is not appearing large nor competitive. The expectation for women is that they inhibit all qualities that are aggressive or victorious. Feminine women are not ruthless, not aggressive, nor victorious. It's not feminine to have a desire to win. The only winning involved in femininity is winning the male approval. The definition of femininity may not be necessarily the same across cultures, but in conventional Western communities, being feminine is often characterized by having dainty, polite, and girly qualities. The Barbie doll is one of the distinct images of femininity in North American culture. The doll has very unrealistic proportions to the actual average human woman. The doll, although versatile in her outfits and the sports she plays, still maintains this physique. It is quite obvious that she has a small waist and small legs. Western cultures continue to focus on the necessity of a flawless and delicate body to correspond with the weak and passive qualities associated with women. This view is further amplified by the basic assumption that women are weaker than men, which can possibly constrain both genders and place limitations on females who wish to pursue successful careers in sports. The concept of gender is one that is instilled in us at birth and attempts to define, evaluate, and classify males and females. The global concept of gender is subdivided into two bipolar constructs, masculinity and femininity. The standard body type for females, thin, yet toned and lean, while males are expected to have large muscles that are toned and well-defined. Athletic women face a dilemma. They are expected to succeed in their sport while still being feminine, which can be a difficult balance to establish and maintain. This conflict describes what is referred to as the female athlete paradox. Female athletes are faced with the task of learning how to balance femininity and athleticism, both on and off the field, in order to be accepted into today's modern culture.
Describe how you think a female athlete is supposed to look based on societal standards.
I think society have these expectations for female athletes that you have to be both skinny and strong. So you can't be overweight. You have to be thin and athletic, but also show that you have muscles. So I think that this has evolved over time. And now we have different role models that look differently, but I still think that society expects you to fit a certain mold that is both strong and thin.
What are the different traits between male and female athletes?
Well, I know a lot of the male athletes that I know want to get a lot bigger and stronger than female athletes do. And I definitely know some female athletes who don't want to look too bulky or too muscular, so they try to stay toned.
There are many female athletes today that are breaking down the stereotypes and constraints that they are faced with. Meredith Atwood, for example, started training for triathlons when she was 31 years old. She was 250 pounds. Atwood was overweight and an alcoholic, but she transformed herself into an athlete and a coach of triathlons. Although most athletes do not start out this way or look as Atwood does, she still has a successful athletic career. She even launched a website to share her life story. This website is called swimbikemom.com, which shares her life story and shares that people can break down the boundaries from social constructs on women in sports and actually be successful in whatever they love. Adidas's new ad also highlights women in sports and the different shapes that women can have. They all still can equally be as feminine and talented no matter what their shape or size is. Jen Rhines, who is featured in this commercial, set two U.S. Masters records after turning 40 years old. Although she is older and does not have the youthful bodies that many athletes acquire, she still is extremely talented and successful in her sport.
Describe how you think a female athlete is supposed to look based on society's ideals.
Society's ideals have kind of changed over the years, but I think nowadays a female's body should typically, like an athletic female body, should typically be a little bit skinnier and sculpted, is kind of what you see in the media nowadays. the only example I can really think of is being Serena Williams, who is just unbelievably jacked. But nowadays you have people who are a little bit slender, but expected to be really muscular, but not to an extent where the muscularity seems manly in a way. So it is kind of a double-edged sword.
You throw like a girl. This is a common insult we have all grown up hearing. Women in sports are consistently belittled while men's sports are consistently being streamed live in bars, homes, and public places around the country. In Embracing Victory, Nelson writes, "Femininity by definition is not large, not imposing, not competitive. Feminine women are not ruthless, not aggressive, not victorious. It's not feminine to have a killer instinct, to want to win with all of your heart. In women's sports today, there resides a notion that women find different values in sports than males. Women feel that the we matters in sports. In contrast, men are seen as less relationship-oriented. This notion expresses that men and women play sports for different reasons and are fueled differently." In one psychology study, psychologists Kimberly Hively and Amani El Alahi conducted a test where college men and women whom were tennis and basketball players, were asked to perform two tasks. One task was difficult and took lots of concentration. The other was an easier speed task. They told some of the participants that there was a gender difference on the tasks to introduce stereotype threat. The other group of participants were told that there was no difference in performance based on gender prior to the tasks. On the difficult task, the women performed worse only when the stereotype threat was included. The easy task was unaffected by the threat. This one minor comment about the difficult athletic task completely altered the mindset of the women, possibly subconsciously, and caused them to do worse than they would have otherwise done. The pressure on women athletes is immense, especially considering that in Western culture, women's athletics is separate and below men's. Some studies show that around age 13, boys are around 12% stronger than girls in lower body strength and 23% stronger in their upper body. By 17, this figure jumps to 50% stronger than girls in lower body strength. While biologically speaking, males are inherently more prone to building muscle, it is obvious that as young women in puberty, comments like, "you throw like a girl," would not create a woman who felt empowered by sports and felt continuously successful competing. But while stereotype threat illustrates a big issue for women's athletics, it may also serve as a catalyst in some instances. When a woman uses the negative comments as fuel to perform even better than she may have otherwise done in order to surpass her male counterparts. Assuming that a woman cannot perform as well as a man extends even farther than athletics, but it is prevalent in the way femininity and the body are idealized in women's athletics and how they are affected by disruptive negative thinking.
How do you think a female athlete is supposed to look?
I think a female athlete should look however they feel most comfortable and however they feel best about themselves. And I think oftentimes society puts a lot of pressure on girls and women to look a certain way. But when you're playing a sport, I think the only way your body should look is the way that's going to maximize your strength and success in whatever sport you're playing.